Good evening, students, and welcome back to our online classes of English language, Standard 5. So, students, if you jog your memory, you will remember that in the last period we have started adjectives, and we have also studied what do you mean by adjectives and what is the use of adjective in language. So, previously, I have told you students that if we want to go out for a celebration or if we want to go out for a party, at that time we decorate ourselves. We decorate ourselves nicely to represent ourselves. Like that, if we want to decorate our language, if we want to give a very impressive presentation, for that we need to decorate our language, and for that we need various adjectives, and adjectives plays the role of decorating our language, and that adjectives make our language very impressive. Now, students, previously we have done various exercises up to question number E. Now, the remaining exercise that we are going to see now. Okay? Now, here is question number F. Choose and write correct adjective from exercise E. Okay? So, previously, before this question number F, recently, we have solved question number E. And from that question number E, we have to choose adjectives to solve this exercise. So, you have to take out your English grammar textbook. You have to keep it in front of you. And now see on page number 44, question number E. From that question number E, you have to choose the adjectives to fill in the blanks of question number F. Now, students, see, this sweater is made of wool. It is a dash dash sweater. Now, see, the sweater is made up of wool. And what is the word that is given here on page number 44? That is woolen. Made up of wool, and it is a woolen sweater. So, the answer of this first sentence is woolen sweater. Okay. Now see, the path was full of stones. It was a dash dash path. Now see here in question number E, the word the path of full of stones means we have to use their word stony. It was a stony path. S-T-O-N-Y. Stony path. Now, the queen sat on a throne made of gold. So, it was a dash dash throne. Golden throne. Made up of gold, we can say it golden. Golden throne. Okay? That's like question number 4, sentence number 4. The road was filled with danger. As the road was filled with danger, and it was a dash dash road. So we have to use here dangerous. The word dangerous. Dangerous road. Yeah. Now fifth sentence. That man is a fool. What a dash dash idea he has. Now see, we are just saying like that. See, that man is looking very fool. And what a dash dash idea he has. So we have to use according to the adjective foolish. Foolish idea. Foolish idea he has. That man is a fool. What a foolish idea he has. Like this we have solved question number F also. Now let's move further. Now students, we are going to see the use of each and every. Now see here, we are using each. When we are talking about people or things are taken separately. Whenever we want to talk about the people or the things separately, one by one. Or whenever we want to address the people one by one, or whenever we want to talk about the people one by one, at that time we have to use each. And then second is every. We use every when we want to mention all the people, everyone. Everyone means every person or more than two people or things. Or we want to mention more than two people or things. At that time we have to use every. Okay. For example, see the example of each. If I say each student must participate in essay competition, it means that each student sitting on the bench or each student of fifth standard class must participate in essay competition. Okay, that is the meaning what I want to say. But if I want to use every, okay, every student participate in drawing competition, it means that every student of standard fifth has participated in the competition. Okay, so like that. Now see question number H. Now students, see question number H. Use the adjectives each and every correctly. So the sentences are given here and you have to use the adjective each and every. So first one is dash dash guest stood up as the president walked in. So what we will write here? We will write each guest, underline this word, each guest stood up as the president walked in. You have to take pencil in your hand and open your textbook page number 45 and you have to write with me, okay, as I am writing on the board. Now see second sentence, dash dash citizen is proud of his country. So what we will use here? Every. We will use the word every. Every citizen is proud of his country. Yes, we really have to be proud of our country. Now see third sentence, dash dash mango is ripe and juicy. We are talking about every mango, okay? So each, we are talking about, suppose there are bunch of mangoes and we want to talk each one of it, okay? We have to talk separately about it, and that time we will use each mango. We want to talk separately about the mangoes. So each mango is ripe and juicy. Make sure that dash dash student behaves well. Okay. Make sure that every student, what we will write here? Every student. Make sure that dash dash students behave well. 1 minute. Every will not come here. We have to write here each. Make sure that each student. We have to write here each. Make sure that each student behaves well. Then fifth, dash dash day seem to pass by slowly. Every day. What word we will use here? Every day. Every day seem to pass by slowly. Then sixth one, I travel dash dash day. I travel every day. Okay, like this. Now see the next sentence. Now see students, sentence number 7. dash dash of the three houses has its own entrance. So we will write here each of. We have to write here each of the three houses has its own entrance. Now eight, sentence number eight. I can see cars parked dash dash where. So obviously we have to use here everywhere. Okay. We go to church dash dash Sunday. We go to church every Sunday. And last but not least one, sentence number 10. Dash dash table at the restaurant is occupied. We will have to wait. So each table of the restaurant is occupied. We will have to wait. So like this, we have also completed question number H. Now see, again there are adjectives like either and neither. You can say it either or neither. Now see, we are going to see how to use that adjectives in the sentences. Okay. So the use of adjectives either and neither. You can say either or neither, or you can pronounce it either or neither. Now see, the first is either. Either is used to talk about the two persons or things, one or the other. Okay? We use either when we want to talk about the two persons or the two things. Now we use neither, not the one or the other. We are using neither for not the one or the other persons. Now see the examples. First one is the example of either. I am not sure who I met, either Mr. Bose or Mr. Nair. It means that one or the other. Means I am not confirmed whom I met, but I think I have met either Mr. Bose or Mr. Nair. Means one of them. Second sentence is of neither. I have met neither Mr. Bose nor Mr. Nair. So it means that not met the two. Means not, I have not met both of them. Okay. So like this we can use the either and neither in the sentences. Now we are going to do the next exercise, that is question number I. Now students, see question number I. Use either in the sentence, in these sentences. Means in all sentences you have to use either. You have to write down either. Now see the first sentence. Dash dash Susan or Shelly can go to the party. And in the bracket it is given, both cannot go together. Both cannot go together. So we have to write here either Susan or Shelly can go to the party. It means that both cannot go together. Second sentence, who will carry this basket? Either Dad or I will. So you have to write here either Dad or I will. Next sentence, where is that book? Dash dash here or on the table? Either here or on the table. Fourth sentence is dash dash answer is correct. This one or that. So we have to write here either means both the answers, this one or that one is correct. Then fifth one, dash dash you are right or I am. Either you are right or I am. So again you have to write here either. So you can guess that, or you can see that we have used either in all these sentences, and that is given in the question. Use either in these sentences means In all the sentences, we have to use either. Now see the next one. Now question number J. Use neither in these sentences as we have previously done. In question number I, you have to use in each and every sentence either. So like that, you have to use neither in all these sentences. Okay. So the first one is, both the boys are naughty. - one is a good boy. So we have to write here neither. Neither one is a good boy. See the second sentence, - team won. The game ended in a draw. Means not a single team has won. Okay. So we have to write here neither team won. The game ended in a draw. It means that the game ended in a draw. Means their match is draw. Then third sentence, - Susan or nor Shelly go to the party. It means that we have to write here neither Susan or nor Shelly go to the party. Next one is, where is father? He is - in the house nor in the garden. So mother is asking, where is father? He is neither in the house nor in the garden. Both knives are blunt. - can cut this string. Neither. You have to write here again neither. Neither can cut this string. So like this, we have finished all the exercise up to J, and I hope that students, you have understood it well. Now I just want to say that you have to keep practicing these sentences, read out these sentences and just try to understand the meaning of each word, the use of each word or each adjective in the sentences. So this comes the end of the session. Today I would like to stop here, and soon I will be back with a new lesson. Till then, you have to take care of yourself. Once again, take care of yourself, stay home and stay safe. Thank you. Bye bye.